Remove both the end caps from the table attachment rod. Insert the dual lock assembly into the pipe. Unlock the grub screws and the side railing clamps. Insert the bush of the side railing assembly into the TA rod. Adjust the width between side railing clamps to fit into the OT table side railings and insert the same. Lock the grub screws. Lock the bolts on both the sides firmly. Close the caps. Loosen the security screw on the dual lock. Insert the EF attachment into it. And lock the screw back. Position the assembly as required and lock the dual lock bolt. Also, lock the ball and socket assembly with the BS bolt. Position the BS assembly at the extra flexion joint as required and lock using EF bolt. Open the head pin sterilization box. Remove the head holder C from the sterilization box and insert it aligned to the slot on the BS assembly. Lock the bolt. Unlock the head holder C, position the C as required and lock the key. There are three different types of head pins, namely adult, adolescent and pediatric. Choose the required head pin from the sterilization box and insert into the head holder C. Head can be positioned in different ways depending on the area of interest. Let's look at the fixation and supine position first. Prone position. Lateral left position. Lateral right position. Once positioned, drape the patient. Open the basal frame sterilization box. Mount the basal frame on the head holder C and lock using the universal key. Also position the scalp hook holder C and lock using the universal key. Retract the scalp using the scalp hooks and hook the chain at desired position on the fixture. Also insert and lock the patty holder. Insert the instrument receptacle into the holes provided and lock the same using universal key. Insert the armrest into the holes provided and lock using universal key. Incline the armrest as required and lock using the knob provided. Arms can now be rested on this during surgery. Self-retaining retractor arms are inserted onto the holder and is locked with the key provided. The arms can be positioned in three different directions for the most conducive positioning. The arm is very flexible to position. For better stability, the arm is rested on the basal frame. The tension of the retractor can be adjusted here. Once the arms are positioned as required, they are locked. On the BS assembly, insert the horseshoe attachment rod and lock using the bolt. Now insert horseshoe gel into the rod, on both the ends and lock using the bolt provided. A weight suspender pulley can be attached for cervical traction applications.